Hello and welcome to Devil's Advocate. Has Nandigram brought the left flank in Bengal to the brink of collapse? That's the key issue I shall discuss today with CPM Rajya Sabha MP and Politburo member Brinda Karat. Mrs. Karat, let me start with a simple question. Do you accept that Nandigram has created serious differences within the left front and damaged the credibility and authority of your chief minister?
Well, there are two questions there as far as the first question is concerned. There were problems. There were some public criticisms made by the other left front partners, and there was a meeting held on March the 17th in Calcutta. An 8-point program has been reached, and I think if all of us try and stick to that program, the problems which are there will be resolved.
Can I pick up on that before we talk about the Chief Minister? You say that if you pick up on the meeting of the 17th, things will be resolved. I point out to you that in fact to begin with, you and your allies can't even agree on the seriousness of what's happened. The CPI says after that meeting, never before has there been such a brutal police assault, and they call it unbelievable and traumatic. The RSP calls it nothing short of barbaric. In contrast, the General Secretary of the CPM dismisses it as merely regrettable and unfortunate. There's a world of difference in the way you see things.
I think the CPIM and our government has expressed its deep regret at the incident. We are deeply distressed because it's poor people who died in the firing. I don't want to reduce it to semantics. The point is we have taken responsibility for it. It was a horrible thing that poor people died. There is a context to it.
Can I ask you a simple question? You don't want to reduce it to semantics. I understand it's too important to be reduced to semantics, but can you accept that it's much more than just unfortunate? You see, what's barbaric is unfortunate. But what's unfortunate is a lot less than barbaric. So can you accept this was barbaric and it was traumatic, which is what your allies want you to accept?
I don't think that is what the allies want us to accept or not. There's an agreement of March 17th. An agreed statement was issued after that agreement, and we stick by that.
Except that I'm quoting Mr. Bardhan of last week.
Mr. Bardhan is a general secretary of his own party. I'm talking about what was agreed in the left front meeting.
It's not just the manner in which you see what's happened. There's an even bigger difference. The general secretary of the CPM says that the allies were consulted and they agreed on the action taken. The allies angrily and loudly say they were never consulted and they completely disagree. Let me quote Mr. Bardhan from New Age of last week. He says, the chief minister and some of his colleagues felt that they could carry through everything without the need for any consultation with or help from other partners of the front. They, the other partners, remained in the dark about everything that was happening. Once again, you and your allies are completely at odds with each other.
Well, this is the left front in West Bengal. And the left front in West Bengal, again, I would repeat, met on March 17th. There were many issues which were discussed there. An agreed statement was issued, and one of the points in the agreed statement is that we will not make public criticisms of each other.
But they've already been made public.
Well, and you see, you'll have to ask those who are doing it.
You keep talking about the meeting on March 17th. The problem is Mr. Karat said that the allies were on board at the last meeting on March 10. Now let me quote to you what D. Raja told CNBC. With all the authority at my command, he says, my party leadership in the state was not present in the so-called 10th March meeting. Abani Roy, he says clearly, there was no such meeting on 10th March in Calcutta, in Alimuddin Street. No meeting was there at all. So
no,
who
well,
do
he's
believe?
Right. He's quite right to say
in
there was
case,
no meeting.
Karat is wrong.
No, he's right to say there was no meeting in Alimuddin Street. There was a meeting at the district level called by the district administration in which the plan for going into Nandigram and to assure the rule of the administration in Nandigram was discussed and decided. Now,
who was present? D. Raja says the CPI wasn't present.
No, of course. The record shows that they were present.
But you, with all the authority at my command, my state party leadership was not present in the so-called 10th March meeting.
That may be so. I'm not saying his state party leadership was present. At the Nandigram district level, there was an all-party meeting. The CPI and everybody else was present.
The question at heart here is, were your allies properly consulted? Even Jyoti Basu seems to suggest that the allies weren't consulted. This is what he told India Today last week. Popular perception is that this is a one-party government. I also have that perception. This lack of communication and mistrust of others was a mistake on our part. You see, even Jyoti Basu disagrees with Prakash Karat's claim. He agrees instead with Bardhan, Raja and Abani Roy.
No, I don't think I'd put it like that at all. I don't know the date of the interview.
Second April issue of India Today.
Again, I would refer to the March 17th meeting. All these issues were discussed in that meeting. They were thrashed out in the meeting and an agreement has been reached. And what I want to state very categorically is that we are committed to the left front. There are ups and downs in our relationship, but everybody knows that the left front is crucial, not only for Bengal, but for national
politics. This is why I'm doing this interview. You see, you keep saying that on the meeting of the 17th of March, everything was sorted out. But A.B. Bardhan, writing in New Age last week, in fact, has accused the CPM of arrogance and conceit. He says, self-conceit and arrogance could be the undoing of the left front. Its biggest partner has to give up its self-complacence. It has to mend its ways. And worse, Manoj Bhattacharjee of the RSP almost withdrew his ministers from the government. So I put it to you. Is your party complacent? Is it conceited? Is it arrogant?
Well, as far as my party is concerned, what I can say is that we are committed to the left front. If people would like, they think it will help the left front by making such public criticism, well, it's up to them. As far as we are concerned, we are committed. As the largest party in the front, with the greater responsibility to keep the front going, to the March 17th.
But are you arrogant?
Look, the people of West Bengal don't think we're arrogant.
Well, we don't know, as they'll tell us in 4 years' time when they vote.
These are just terms which I don't really give much credence to. What I do say is, it is important to have a coordination with the left front, between the left front and all its partners, whether it's with two parties, whether it's all the parties together. And we are going to, if there have been any problems which our partners feel, the left front in West Bengal is mature enough to deal with it.
Bardhan says that this is one of the biggest crises the left front in Bengal has ever faced. Do you agree?
Well, there have been other crises.
But is it one of the biggest?
When Mr. Bardhan's party actually had left the left front and gone with the Congress. So there have been other crises.
There's a bit of tit for tat in your answer. You're suddenly finding a need to hit back.
No, I'm not at all. I'm just, recounting history.
But is this
just
one of
for the record, and therefore, because there have been such great crises, there was another great crisis in 1975, when during the emergency we found ourselves.
You're not answering my question. Is this one
of
the biggest crises?
I don't think it's one of the biggest crises. As I said, there was a crisis when there was no front. Therefore, there is a front. There was a problem. The problem, I believe, has been resolved. In the meeting of March 17th, we have to take that process forward.
Well, you say it's been resolved. Your allies clearly don't indicate the same. Let's leave that issue there. The audience will judge whether there is a serious difference between you and your allies or not. Let me now turn to your chief minister. I want to ask you whether you think he's handled this issue adequately or not, because Jyoti Basu, just last week to India Today, says he's disappointed with Buddhadev Bhattacharjee. Is Jyoti Basu being unfair?
I really can't say what Comrade Jyoti Basu has said, but what I can say is that our chief minister is the leader of a collective.
Are you disappointed with him?
There's a question of mine being disappointed with him or any
Jyoti Basu is.
I'm afraid I can't answer that question in terms of what Comrade Jyoti Basu has said. I can say, as far as I'm concerned, we work in a collective. We have a collective responsibility, and certainly in a situation like this, we are not going to be pinpointing this individual or that individual.
Okay, you say you
there
work
is a process, but I would like to say that there is a process of internal assessments, of a self-critical analysis. That is a process which is intrinsic to my party's democratic functioning, which we will certainly be doing.
In that spirit, therefore, and because you say you work as a collective, I want to point out to you what Mr. Bardhan has said about the functioning of the chief minister. He says the chief minister's style shows an over-dependence on the bureaucracy and the police. Jyoti Basu, his predecessor, the grand old man of your party, says, Buddhadev Bhattacharjee doesn't meet me. It would have been good if he did. Even in the government, he doesn't discuss things with others.
I don't agree with that. And I really I think the way he's been quoted, I really can't guarantee that that is exactly what he said.
He hasn't denied it, and it's been a week since he allegedly said it.
So I'm not going to comment on that. As far as Comrade Bardhan is concerned, as the General Secretary of the CPI, I'm sure he is very responsible in the statements that he is making. So I'll just leave it at that.
Let me ask you a critical question. Has Buddhadev Bhattacharya cut himself off or distanced himself from people whose advice he needs and should be taking?
I don't think so at all, because there is a collective, and I want to stress, there is a collective in my party. It is not a one-man government.
But is it functioning as a collective? Because that's the point these people are making.
As far as my party is concerned, we are very clear. It is a collective. The mistakes, the achievements, everything is collective. And therefore, what I would say is, the problems which preceded Nandigram, the problems which we face today, are things which the party is dealing with. It is a collective effort of the party to deal with the events both before
That's
and
why
after
I'm pursuing
Nandigram.
It by pointing out to you that perhaps the worst indictment and charge against the Chief Minister is that he knowingly sent the police force into Nandigram knowing that there would be lives that would be lost. Kshiti Goswami,
Kshiti Goswami,
your minister in your government, the PWD minister, has gone on record to say the government very well knew things would go out of hand and lives could be lost. They went ahead despite that.
Well, what I would say that it is entirely unfortunate that anybody should ever think that the Chief Minister of West Bengal would ever knowingly...
His cabinet colleagues saying it.
Well, I mean, there may be reasons for him to have said it, but what I'm saying
Can
to
I
you
ask
in
you
this
a quick
interview...
Question? Do you think the Chief Minister made a terrible mistake? Perhaps unwittingly, perhaps without realizing it,
no,
but do you think he made
a
mistake?
I cannot at all say that. In any case, there's an investigation on. There is a CBI inquiry. There is a CID inquiry. We'll have to wait for the facts.
Very quickly, I am told by Avani Roy on a CNBC program that Nandigram has resulted in a collapse of trust for the whole left front in Bengal and perhaps for the Chief Minister specifically.
Well, I hope events will persuade Mr. Avani Roy that he is wrong.
You mean to say that all your allies, including Jyoti Basu, including Avani Roy, including Kshiti Goswami, including Bardhan, in all their comments are wrong, and only the CPM view is correct?
I won't put it that way, but I would say after the March 17th agreement, I'm sure these very experienced leaders will be persuaded to work according to that
agreement.
When you
agreement. Say persuaded, do you mean arm twisted and bullied by the bigger partner?
We never do that.
You never admit to it? Let's take a break.
Not on this program.
not on this program, but perhaps...
That's a joke, Karan.
Let's take a break and let's come back and talk to you about Governor Gopal Gandhi's statement of March the 14th. How do you respond to that? That's in a moment's time. See you after the break. Welcome back to Devil's Advocate and an interview with CPM Rajya Sabha MP and Politburo member Brinda Karat. Mrs. Karat, let's turn to the statement issued on the 14th of March by Governor Gopal Gandhi. He asks, was this spilling of human blood not avoidable? What's your answer?
He's the governor and a constitutional authority.
Absolutely, but what's your answer to the question?
No, I can't comment on that.
I'm not asking you to comment on it. I'm asking you to answer it.
No,
Was the spilling of blood not avoidable?
I'd prefer not to answer that question.
Because it's embarrassing?
Because, not because it's embarrassing, but because there is a context to it and there is an inquiry, an investigation which is on, which would answer the governor's question.
But the governor asked a simple question. You're treating it as if it was either rhetorical or worse, as if it was done to politically undermine the government.
No. That's what you're trying to put a color on that. No, I didn't say that at all.
All right.
I'm very serious about it.
The governor went a step further. The governor also said in his statement, I leave it to the conscience of the officials responsible to atone for the event in the manner they deem fit. First of all, do you believe that atonement is called for?
I really couldn't say that's the Honourable Governor's sentiment. As far as we are concerned, there's an investigation which is on. The investigation is expected to pinpoint responsibility, and we'll take it from there.
No, but he's not talking about an investigation now. He's talking about an act of atonement done by the officials responsible. Clearly, that means
well,
the government of the day.
We first have to decide who the officials are responsible
well, presumably
are
the
and
chief
what,
minister is
and
one of
what
them.
They are responsible for.
Well, surely.
So what I believe that there is an investigation on, and I would not like to preempt that by making any comment on what the governor has advised or suggested.
And there's something very interesting. You're saying you need to go through an investigation to decide, A, whether atonement is called for, and then who atones. If the governor has asked for atonement in advance of that investigation, are you suggesting that he's jumping the gun?
Well, that's for you to decide, but as far as I'm concerned, certainly as far as the answer to that question is, I would wait for the investigation and the inquiry.
If the investigation and the inquiry were to show that the officials responsible, perhaps all the way up to the Chief Minister himself, had something to atone for, would we or could we expect a public apology?
I don't believe in ifs and buts. Let's wait.
Your my governor politics. Does.
I can't comment on that, Karan, but what I would say is I would wait for the investigation and we'll take it from there.
All right. The third thing the governor raises in his statement is the following. He says, I also expect the government to do what it thinks is necessary to mitigate the effects of this bitter March 14 and to do it visibly and fast. What steps has your government in Bengal taken to heed the governor's advice?
Well, I really can't say what the governor actually meant, but I'm sure he would have explained to the Chief Minister or let the Chief Minister know what was on his mind. They have met after that, and I'm sure the Chief Minister would have explained his point of view to the governor.
The Chief Minister
and
is a colleague
our
of yours.
Major,
did you not ask the Chief Minister what the governor had said?
No, we don't work like that. The point is that we have a plan forward in Nandigram, and the first thing about Nandigram is to normalize the situation.
All right.
And that is very, very crucial.
Let's leave the governor aside. Clearly, this is too awkward, too tricky, too politically sensitive an issue for you to comment on, although clearly also your party is deeply embarrassed. Let's come instead to Biman Bose, the chairman of the Left Front in Bengal, the state secretary of your party, the CPM. Mr. Bose has publicly criticized the Calcutta High Court for ordering a CBI inquiry. He says the court has, and I quote, clearly jumped the gun. The judiciary has undermined the democratic framework of the state by playing an unnecessarily proactive role. Do you agree with Mr. Bose?
Well, the fact of the matter is that there is a case at present going on in the Supreme Court which has been referred to a larger bench, which is precisely the issue of whether a high court can, without even giving the state government a chance for even a hearing, to order a CBI inquiry. Because law and order is a state subject.
So are you saying that you agree with Mr. Bose that the High Court has undermined the democratic framework?
No, what I'm saying is the Supreme Court also believes that there is an issue here, which is why
that's
discussing
another matter
the issue.
Criticizing the Calcutta High Court. Do you agree that Mr. Bose was right to criticize the Calcutta High Court?
Well, I won't say, don't call it criticism. He's raised a question.
Oh, forgive me. According to the Hindu, he's even used language that many would consider objectionable. He says the court is like, and I quote, a giant crab trying to eat into the very foundations of democracy. Is it fitting that the chairman of the Left Front should talk of the Calcutta High Court like a giant crab?
Well, I really am.
Oh, you're right, it's laughable, but it's been done.
This is the first time I'm hearing such a description.
Hindu, March
but
the 25th.
What I would say is that there's a substantive issue. Even if we just put the language aside for a minute, there is a substantive
Do you agree with the language?
Well, I won't say I agree or disagree with it. It's a way of speaking.
Could Mr. Bose have praised himself more felicitously?
No, I don't need to comment. Why don't you ask him? I don't need to comment on that.
That's the first hint that you don't endorse it when you say
no,
ask him.
No, it's not a question of endorsing it.
People say that Nandigram and the manner in which the CPM has responded to Nandigram is the beginning of the end of Left Front rule in Bengal.
Well, you know, we've heard such dreams expressed again and again.
You sure this won't become your nightmare?
And I can tell you we are deeply distressed about the fact that poor people have died in Nandigram. We believe that it is essential.
But is this the end of Left Front rule?
No, I doubt it, because we are very committed.
I doubt
to,
it doesn't sound
to
like
the people
no.
of this country. It is no.
Tindakara, a pleasure talking to you on Devil's Advocate.